Hello YouTube and hello to my dear subscribers. Welcome to another video from Karda. And today I'm gonna make... Well, it has been a while since I made a collection video. Today I opened my suitcase where I store all my PlayStation Portable and Nintendo DS games in. And... I ordered them all alphabetically. And well, today I wanted to make a video about the DS games that I have. And including I will do the 3DS games as well. And the 3DS game is just a very little stack, so I start with the 3DS games. And well, that suitcase, I hadn't opened it for like 6 or 7 months. So when I looked through the games again, I was especially with the PlayStation Portable games, there are still a lot of games I have not played yet, and with the DS as well, of course. And I was, well, a little bit more amazed by the PlayStation Portable games. Van, oh yeah, I want to play that one, and oh yes, I want to play that one as well. So yeah, tomorrow or the day after, I want to do the PlayStation Portable as well, to show the games that I have. And I think I'm gonna call this video my GRPG Japanese role playing games collection, because more than 90% is Japanese in origin. Those are the games I like best, story wise and. Well, yeah, I was never very fond of Western RPGs. There are some exceptions, like Baldur's Gate. That is truly an amazing experience. Baldur's Gate 1 and 2 on the PC. If you like, it's Dungeons and Dragons based, and I liked that very much. As well as Neverwinter Nights. That was the next step for BioWare, but that's besides the point, of course. So let's start with I call it the poor man's collection. It's not very much. I gradually bought some games each month, and I do not have lots of money to spend on games like other people do, so I'm very happy with what I have. And maybe you see some titles you never you haven't played, or maybe something will interest you while watching this video. So let's start with a very small stack of 3DS games. And like my DS games, I ordered them alphabetically, so we're gonna go from A to Z, A to Z. And the first 3DS game I want to show is Animal Crossing. Very, very addictive game. When I bought it, I think I played it for maybe 6, 7, or 8 weeks. Intensively, and it was basically my first time that I played an Animal Crossing game. So so everything was new, and I can imagine if you played other Animal Crossing games before, then it's a bit of the same, of course. But for me, it was the first time, and on the 3DS, it's very, very, very well worked out. You can visit towns from other people who are playing the game online, and that's not region locked. You can visit towns from people in Japan or USA or Mexico or whatever. So it's an international server where you connect to, and if you have somebody in your friends list, you can visit his town, or he can visit yours. So I had a great time with this game, building my town. And after that, I kind of stopped playing. If you have give me one moment, I again forgot to plug in the power to my laptop, so I need a few seconds. Well, that was it. So, Animal Crossing, I liked very much for the time that that I played it. And the second 3DS game is Devil Survivor Overclocked. It's the first Devil Survivor, the remake from the normal DS one. And here in Europe it was released by Ghostlight a few months ago. So we are... some games get released here very late. Or some even never. So I still have to play this one. But I like Devil Survivor 2 very much on the dual screen. So I could not afford to miss out on this. And of course Etrian Odyssey 4. And I basically have to put my teeth in this game. I played a few levels. But I have to continue someday. And Fire Emblem Awakening. Truly an amazing game. I like Fire Emblem very much. And this with the Street Pass and all the extras on the 3DS is... very enjoyable game to play. Very recommendable. Then the Project X Zone. And well, there are only two characters I know in this game, and that are the Tales of Vesperia characters, and the rest of the characters are unknown to me. And what happened in the first Project X or Project Zone, that story I missed as well. So when I started playing this story, I have totally no clue who the people are, what the story is all about. And well, gameplay wise, it's a bit strange. It's strategy, but strange. Then the Soul Hackers, Shin Megami Devil Summoner. I can say it's a port of the older, of the original Soul Hackers. Very hard game. And to my opinion, not so worthy for the 3DS. They could have done much better. And I got to put my teeth in this game as well someday. Then which logo I use as thumbnail for my username on YouTube since I started, that's Tales of the Abyss. Still my favorite Tales of game I ever played. And if I'm gonna replay Tales of the Abyss, I'm sure not gonna do it on the 3DS, but do it on the PlayStation 2, to my opinion, where it belongs, with a controller and a big screen. A truly amazing RPG. Another very, very, very good game, the sequel to 999 for the DS, Virtue's Last Reward. To my opinion, one of the best 3DS games that's out there. Lots of voice acting, great graphics, great story. It's very praiseworthy. If you have not played this one, try to get a copy and play it. It's a visual novel, but with lots of puzzles. Great story. Recommended is play 999 first on the DS. Before you start playing this. And the last one already is Zelda. I bought it when I bought the 3DS. At that moment there were not many games out. But I'm very bad in platform gaming. So that's a very shame. I'm almost unable to play Kingdom Hearts. It's too hard for me. And with Zelda, I have the same problem. But with the 3DS and Zelda. So that's the 3DS games. I would have bought Etrian Odyssey Millennium Girl if it was released in Europe. And if the 3DS was region locked, I would have imported it. But that game is very unavailable here in Europe. As well as Shin Megami Tensei 4. I would have loved to have that game as well. But the region lock, and because it's never released here, I'm unable to play that. And I'm thinking of waiting for the new Inazuma something, that soccer team. I think that could be a nice RPG-ish game. And of course Pokemon Y or Pokemon X. I'm waiting for to buy that as used game, like Inazuma. So that's the 3DS. Let's start with the Nintendo DS games. And that's well, a bit more than the 3DS, of course. And I hope the 3DS at the end of its lifespan would have as many good RPG games as the DS has or had. And as well alphabetically, so I think you know which game will come first, and that's basically one of the best dual screen games available. It's 999, a visual novel, but the story pulls you in so fast, and the puzzles are good, and the story, yeah, that I always said. Lots of endings, great story, very good gameplay, highly, highly, highly recommendable. And I heard that there is a rerun, so it should be available again. So if you have not picked 999 up yet, run to the stores. Then Advance Wars Dual Strike. To play in the hours when I like to play a war-based strategy game. And these are not easy games. They get very hard after a few levels. So, yeah. Very enjoyable. Then the Advance Wars Dark Conflict. And here we have... oh wait, I forgot something to mention. 999 is an import game. Never been released in Europe. I want to mention that with each game that is imported. And that's the same with Chrono Trigger. As you can see, this is a USA box. No release in Europe. And... well, I'm ashamed to say I still have to play Chrono Trigger, and I heard so many people say good things about this game, but, and I still have to play it. I only played the first 10 minutes or so on the festival with the fireworks and some attractions, some stuff you can do, but I never went further in the game. So, still have to play Chrono Trigger someday. Really, really, really have. I want to know what all people... why it's such an amazing game. And another, to my opinion, very high recommendable game is Devil Survivor 2. Yeah. It's so far my favorite tactical... RPG I ever played. I like this one even better than Final Fantasy Tactics. Probably because it's due to the persona fusing, which has worked out great in this game. Yeah, very enjoyable, highly recommendable, Devil Survivor 2. And you have to play the game twice to get the true ending. And well, I completed it once, so I still have to complete it one more time, one day. Then we get the Dragon Quests. Dragon Quest, The Hand of the Heavenly Bride, I think that is number 4 in the series. Yeah, it's Dragon Quest, great games. Dragon Quest, I think this is the number 5. And that is called The Chapters of the Chosen. And this one I... one of those two I completed. Can't remember which one. Number 6. Which I never played. Realms of the Reverie. So there's still an... two Dragon Quests I have not played on the DS. Dragon Quest 9. A little bit, it's a good Dragon Quest, but a little bit disappointing because there's basically only the main character that has a story. And the other characters you can, if I'm correct, create yourself. So they have no story. The good thing is the map. When you walk around, you see a very detailed map. And that aspect I liked very much. And two spin-offs of the Dragon Quests. Dragon Quest Monster Joker. Haven't played it actually. And that's the same for 2. Haven't played that one neither. So that's the end of the D. Let's start with the E. A new little stack. And the first one I come that comes with the E is Etrian Odyssey 1. Probably because it was the first time that I actually played Etrian Odyssey, and because I, well, almost never played a dungeon crawler, I enjoyed Etrian Odyssey 1 very, very much. Yeah. Dungeon crawling, everyone who knows Etrian Odyssey, I guess. And Etrian Odyssey 1 sold very bad in Europe, and that's why they only released 1. So I had to, as you can see in another black box, import the 2 games. And that's Etrian Odyssey 2. Yeah. Maybe an Etrian Odyssey overkill those days. I did not enjoy it very much. The classes were very different than 1. So I had a hard time with Etrian Odyssey 2 actually. And of course another USA only title, Etrian Odyssey 3. I wanted to have the complete series. So that's why I want Millennium Girl to be released here as well, of course. And then we come to... I see I have not ordered those. Now I have. The Final Fantasies. Final Fantasy 3. Which I still have to play. Final Fantasy 4. Which I still have to play. Final Fantasy 12, which I still have to play, but I want to play that once I played Final Fantasy 12 on the PlayStation 2, which I still have not played as well. And then some spin-offs is Final Fantasy Tactics A2. Yeah. I had a problem with at the one moment you have to send parties out to do some quests, and I lost interest at that point. Final Fantasies Echoes of Time, cross-playable with the Wii, but basically I did not enjoy it very much. I played it with Atticus MJ. I think we played it both on the Wii, and there is very, very much lag on the... You play through a Nintendo server, so it's not peer-to-peer. And it's unplayable, really. we had some other experiences with games playing peer to peer, and that went without problem. But with this game, it was one or two seconds lag. That's too much to have fun online. Then the four Heroes of Light, which I heard some good things from. I think it was Michael Monti, but I still have to experience this game myself. And another game that was so hard to find here. That's Fire Emblem Shadow Dragon. That was really hard to find here. Especially because I started collecting games much too late. So Fire Emblem had been released already for a few years, and or it did not sell well, or nobody wants to sell it. And well, I can understand the nobody wants to sell it part. It's Fire Emblem, and yeah, great games. Then Golden Sun Dark Dawn. I enjoyed the Game Boy Advance Golden Sun duo games very much, and I played this one for like 10 minutes, and there's only one thing on my mind is why did you go 3D graphics? They should have kept the 2D graphics, which I, for me, Golden Sun is still the old series on the Game Boy Advance, and they should have sticked with 2D graphics. To my opinion, the DS is best in 2D. It's not, it works 3D, but it's not a 3D machine, not like the PlayStation Portable is or was, to my opinion. So they should have stick to 2D graphics, but no, they went to 3D. And another surprisingly very good game, Hotel Dusk Room 215, that's also a visual novel, which I enjoyed very much. I have not completed it, but I played, well, quite far. And it's a very good story, and there's a sequel. I do not know its name at this moment, but I still have to buy the sequel, but I keep spending my money on other games that have a more priority. But if you like visual novels, I think Hotel Dusk 215, if you can find it, will not be expensive. Give it a try. Now I have to grab the other stacks, so one moment. Kingdom Hearts Recoded. Yeah, I'm afraid that's also a platform game, so that will be for me unplayable. Then the 358/2 from Kingdom Hearts. Lost Magic. Glad I bought it for €6. If you are left-handed, unplayable. So there's not much I can say. It's a good game. I have no clue. It's unplayable for left-handed people, like I am. Then a game which I am so. It's also so rare here in Europe, and I'm so glad that I found it last year or something. Luminous Arc 1. I give this game high praises. If you liked Final Fantasy Tactics on the GBA, and if you can find Luminous Arc 1, give it a try. The story is a little bit feel-good story, and it's not advanced strategy, but it's somehow I enjoy this so much. I played it from start to finish in one go, and for me that is I do not have that with many games, but with Luminous Ark I enjoyed so much. Another one I am very happy with that I have it is Luminous Ark 2. It's the little boxed. I think there was only one version that is a little box version. I have not played this one. It's very different than Luminous Ark 1, what I have seen. So I still have to give it a try, and I hope it's enjoyable as the first one was. Yeah, Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. I'm not gonna say anything about this piece of trash. And then we get to the Pokémons. Well, it's Pokémon Platinum, Pokémon Soul Silver. This game comes back in each DS collection video with the Pokéwalker, and I had so much fun with this game. To my opinion, the most enjoyable Pokémon on the DS. And then from the next series, I got Pokémon Black. And then the next series, I got Pokémon White 2. But I'm in such a Pokémon overkill phase that maybe I can enjoy Pokémon X or Y. I hope someday. The Pokémon Mystery Dungeon Blue Rescue Team. I have no clue. And that's the same with Mystery Dungeon Explorers of Time. But I watched the 3DS Mystery Dungeon game and it didn't look very interesting to me, so I'm afraid these two will not be as interesting as well. And the last little stack. Import USA, Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney, because I heard so many good things about other people. I really wanted to check the series out myself. Yeah. It's a good game, but this is enough Phoenix Wright for me. Professor Layton, Curious Village, which is a game which I enjoyed quite a few days. The puzzles are very nice in this game. And because I like this game, I also bought The Dose of Pandora. That's the Box of Pandora, Professor Layton, but translated, this one is a Dutch version. Games in Dutch are a real bore to play, I can assure you. Another import is Radiant Historia. Got lots of good praises by RPG fans, so I had to buy it. And I have the same problem as with Golden Sun, is why did it go 3D? I would have loved to play this game in 2D graphics. And then a strategy game, also an import one, is Rondo of Swords. A strategy RPG, but very, very different than your normal strategy RPG. So I had a hard time loving this game, or liking this game. But it's not an easy game, but very different than the usual. Then another great game which I love to play, Shin Megami Tensei Strange Journey, dungeon crawler in Shin Megami Tensei style. and I had a better experience with this game than with Soul Hackers on the 3DS. But that's personal. Spectral Force Genesis, another import, and I think it's strategy, but I have not played it yet. And that's the same for Valkyrie Profile. I heard it's a strategy RPG, so it could be interesting. Then Ease Strategy, which as a game is worthless. It's a bit Age of Empires kind of game, but on the small DS screen and with graphics, well, even the old Nintendo system, Nintendo Entertainment System, looks better than this. I was very disappointed with this game, but it's Ease, so I wanted to have it. And that's basically the same, which and with this game I'm very happy to have it. Is the Ease book 1 and 2 for the dual screen, of course. Not because I like the game, but because it's Ease and a little bit rare-ish. I tried to find a PlayStation Portable version of this game, but that's really unavailable over here now. And the last two games are basically not worth mentioning. I had a very good experience with the older Yu-Gi-Oh's, but with these Yu-Gi-Oh's are too many cards for me. And then there's there also the 2009 Yu-Gi-Oh. And that's it. Let's look at the time frame. Well, in half an hour, that's not bad. I can recall needing more time for all my DS games. So that's what I have at the moment. And probably there will not be many additions to it. So, thank you for watching, and I hope you have a good time gaming yourself, and you'll sure see me next time.